Dear audience, my name is Ganna Kalagina, and I'm CEO of Citrus Ukraine. And I'm very happy to launch today a series of public talks with international retailers present in Ukraine. This project is organized in partnership with NI Ukraine company. Vitaly Boyko, CEO, is here. And our special guest for the launching of this series is CEO of Decathlon Ukraine, Florian Guillaume. Thank you very much to be here with us.
Hello, Ganna. Hello, Vitaly. Hello, everyone.
Hello, Florian. Hello, Anna.
And it's not an occasional choice. Almost 1 year ago, we had a physical meeting. And we discussed your development plans and general situation on Decathlon Ukraine. So we would like to update the situation. Vitaly will start this part of our interview concerning your development. And just a small maybe announcement for our audience that if you have some questions to Florian or to me or to Vitaly, you can keep them in the chat of YouTube. So please, Vitaly.
Hello, everyone who are watching us. Hello, Anna. Hello, Florian. First of all, let me say a great thank you for Florian, for his time, and for joining our Zoom conference and give us opportunity to understand your current situation and your future plans. And second, I want to say sorry for my English teachers because my English is still poor and I haven't used lockdown time for its improving. And let's start from the questions. First of all, let's imagine what our meeting is 2 months ago, what we are meeting in March 2020. It is only 1 year after your opening in Ukraine, before story of coronavirus, before all these problems and troubles. How you can explain your opinion about your first year, and can you compare maybe first year in Ukraine with opening in other countries? Was the same successful or with some local differences?
Okay. Hello, everyone, again. We opened 1 year ago in a Petrovka retail park, our store of 2,000 square meters. Actually, it was a very good opening. We did a great first day, first weekend, first month, and even first year, because we met the anniversary of 1 year activity on in the end of March. So during a confinement, but we have almost 12 months of business, and we did very well. So after 3 months already of activity, we realized that we were above our target of turnover. So we decided to continue and to accelerate our development. That's why we decided very fast to open another store. So it's where I am today. I am in Belichi store next to Ashan and Lavina. And it's a store of 3,000 square meters, this one. So we have a promising first year of activity. Also in e-commerce, we started just a few weeks before the opening of our first store. And in e-commerce also, we see that each week almost we are growing step by step. So it's also very promising. About comparison with other countries, what I can say in e-commerce, we did better than other countries that start in e-commerce, because very fast, after a few days, we almost reached 100 orders per day, which is quite good to start the business. Now we do a lot more. And in other countries, sometimes it takes some months before they reach 100 orders. So this was a very good news. And I can see that in Ukraine, many customers use digital to purchase goods and sports goods. About the stores, we did more than what we expected, but we did less than other countries where Decathlon is well known. When we open in Morocco, in Algeria, in this country where we speak French, where Decathlon people they know Decathlon since a lot of time because they go to France and so on. We did a lot more in Algeria. The first year for the first store, it will be more than 15 million euros. So which is very good for 1,500 square meter. Here we did less in Ukraine, but what I can see from other countries, it was the same in Romania 10 years ago. I worked there at that time, and we started with the turnover that we did. Then very fast, we multiplied by two. After 4 or 5 years, we multiplied by two our turnover, and then we continue to grow sustainably of plus 20, plus 30% every year for all the first years of activities. So it will. I'm very confident that we will grow and continue to grow in our business here in Ukraine from the experience that I have from other countries. So the first year was positive, promising.
You know.
Great. And let's discuss or let's speak about your future. We understand what current situation, it is unpredictable in all other countries, not only in Ukraine, and it is maybe difficult to understand what is best scenario for future. Is it better to decrease quantity of shops and sales area, or it's better to increase it? First of all, I want to show you only one slide. It's about our searches. Just 1 week ago, we finished research about attitude of all Ukrainians to the shopping centers. Are they ready to visit shopping centers in future with the same so often as before? And I want to show you these figures. If you can look on my screen, you can see figures of our research. Only 44% of Ukrainians are ready to visit shopping centers as often as before, as they visited shopping centers before coronavirus crisis. For example, situation in the United States is a little bit better, 60%, but it's not very good picture, but we can see what only 4% of Ukrainians are not ready to visit shopping centers at all. All other shopping visitors who are not ready to visit shopping center as often as now, as before. First reason is lack of money. Second reason is fear of injection. And from one side, we have such information. From another side, we can read the reports of, for example, the biggest Ukrainian marketplace, Rosetka, which increased sales of goods for sport and for fitness in 2.5 times. And this way, some chains are ready to reduce store quantity and size. Some chains are ready to increase. We believe what you have a positive vision. And please explain us, what is your current vision? How many shops do you want to have in Ukraine, in Kiev? And will you have shops in Kiev's regions?
Okay. Since more than 10 years already, we see that there is an evolution of the how people purchase. Before, it was only in stores, an hypermarket and so on, a big mall. It was where people purchase. Now we have more and more change with the digital, with the e-commerce, but not only through all what we can do in digital, SMM, affiliation, and so on, to work through platform, marketplace, and everything. There is a lot of different ways to do business. And of course, we will be here. We are already, and we will continue to grow. Something that we will keep in Decathlon, it's our big stores, our flagships, because in these stores, we can show who we are. And Decathlon is to make sport accessible to all, to have all the sports, and to be able to show visually the offer that we have, like my wall of balls, for example, or all the offer of badminton over there and everything. we see that with your eyes. You have the customer experience, and we see the power of Decathlon. So we will keep our concept of flagships, definitely. Maybe we will have less than in other countries. In France or in China, we have 300 stores because at that time, in France, we exist since 45 years and the development was only stores. So we open stores. Now we develop a lot the digital part and we have the stores. Here, we can imagine that in Ukraine, we will have big stores in Kiev, 5-6 big stores, like here in where I am, and in the main big cities, Lviv, Dnipro, Odessa, Kharkiv, big store, big flagship Decathlon. And then, in order to multiplicate point of contacts, we will be able to have other concepts, like city center shops, or like smaller shops in malls. We will open one at the end of the week, if everything is okay, in Rive Gauche, 40 square meter shop, with a one-day delivery, click and collect, and so on, very very digital. So something that we will test in a few days, and it's working well in other countries. In Decathlon, you know, we sell products in our retail concept Decathlon, but also 99% of the products that you have here in this store, it's made in Decathlon. It's our own brands. So today you can purchase Nike shoes in Nike shop, but also in other retail shops, and also in Zoom, and also in Reebok. You can purchase Nike shoes everywhere. So in Decathlon it's the same. Today you can purchase Decathlon products inside Decathlon shops, but we plan also to sell them through other partners, or maybe other sports stores. Why not? We have our bicycles in front of me. Between, it's the brand number two in the world for bicycle. We sold more than 10 million in Europe last year of bikes, and I think that we are the only made in Europe bikes in Ukraine. I didn't find other. Maybe you know some brands that are made in Europe, but everywhere I see only made in China or other. We are the only one to do a made in Europe. So we will not sell only inside Decathlon. We will be able to sell also through other partners, or hypermarket, or we will see. But we will be able to extend also like that. So not only big stores, but also partnership, maybe franchise. Why not? Everything is possible.
Thank you. Great news. What brand of bicycle? What logo I should find? It's Decathlon.
It's between. I will show you. It's not very far. Sorry.
It's a minute of advertising.
Yes.
10 million. It's a huge.
Yes. Amount of bicycle. It's these bikes. Let me find the. So actually, we have different brand names now. So we have a Triban, a Van Rysdael. For some people, they
which is the best
Tour de France with it. Or if you want to purchase road bikes, it's a definitive Van Rysdael. So we have top of range for 100,000, but we have also a more accessible one for 29 or 21,000. And our bikes are lifetime guarantee. So we guarantee for all your life the frame of the bike is guaranteed for all the life, because we trust on the quality of our bikes. So we have also mountain bikes over there. The mountain bikes is with the brand Rock Rider, so it's also a Decathlon brand.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, we have for kids and for kids and for city. It's our brand Between. So which is this one? So Between is the second brand in the world. We have also folding bikes, electric bikes, and so on.
You have electric bikes too?
Yeah. Where are they? Okay. We'll find them. Oh, we have a lot of bikes.
Florent, one more question about the format of the shop, because the retail model is changing in general. According to recent research, the majority of customers expect to see almost a half of space of the shops dedicated to some gamification zone and everything with non-standard and non-retail use. Just like an example, you know perfectly House of Innovation done by Nike. What about Decathlon? I know that you already have some very small zones with gamifications and you already use this experience, but maybe some plans for future and for long-term vision. What do you think about this?
Okay. Yes, definitely. So here we have to think about customer experience. For the customer experience, we will improve. So we will put in place in the store something that we do already in other countries. So the payment with self-checkout tills and so on. So this in few weeks, we'll be able to have this. The payment through your cell phone, where you scan with your cell phone, you pay directly. So you don't have to go to the tills. You just go, you scan, you pay, and you leave.
In our shops already?
Not in some shops, not in Ukraine.
Not in Ukraine.
But in many countries we do this already. So this is on the way. We are developing step by step all the innovation in Ukraine that we do in the rest of the world. So we have a lot of different innovation like that. You know, the customers, they want to have they want to be able to purchase anytime, anywhere, and with any device. So any device in the tills or with a laptop, cell phone, and so on and so on. So, and we have to provide this. With the coronavirus, we developed 2 weeks ago the drive-in. So we propose to customers to purchase online and to go in front of the store and to open the trunk, and we deliver directly in the car. So this is something that we do since 2 weeks, and we will continue to do, because even if the store now is open, we have the drive-in, and so maybe there is some cars here. No, not right now, but we have a drive-in, and we propose to the cars to come here. With WhatsApp, they contact our team, and in 1 minute they deliver in the car directly, so they don't have to enter into the store. Then, about what you say about customer experience, there is also the experience just about the experience to live an experience, to have fun in the store, to be able to test the products, to try the products, to play with the products. So this is something that exists in Decathlon since many, many, many years. This is the concept of Decathlon, to be able to test, to have a big place for testing. So unfortunately, with the coronavirus right now, we cannot access to this, but I hope soon we'll be able to come back. Dekoyu, we'll be able to come back to, because I'm in the store, my security manager asked me to put this up. Sorry, to come back to give this accessibility to our customer. It's also to have fun. So we propose also in our store, here we see virtual reality. So right now also it's closed because it's forbidden, but I hope when we have the cure for the coronavirus, we'll be able to open it again and so on. But it's for free. You can take it and you can play inside to dive or to ski and so on. We have different games. We propose also, and we will continue to propose the possibility to play inside the store and to play outside the store. So you know already in Retail Park Petrovka, we plan to build a playground outside. Where we will have a multi-sport area and so on for free for all people if they want to go out, or to test the product, or to just to play, just to have fun. And here in La Vida is the same also. We have the plan. It's agreed already. We will open a multi-sport area, and we'll be able to also to propose this to our customers. So this is part of the concept of Decathlon already since many, many years. And so we will continue to do that, and we will continue to surprise our customer and our visitor. So each time, it will be a new experience. It's very exciting, but it's also the promise of Decathlon.
Okay, So another question regarding clients and clients relationships. So also according to some studies, some clients would like even to share their DNA with chemistry shops or with some medical shops to have a special diet, individual or individual treatment, etc. So globally, the question is about personalization, and it's very popular, and a lot of, also more than 51% of clients are expecting to have some personal consultation in store, and to have that to have a possibility that brands identify all their needs. What do you think about Decathlon? Is it also a good example for mass market, or it's maybe something more correct for premium segment? Are you working already in this sphere?
Yeah, we are mass market, so we sell our products worldwide, and we have some time to adapt the product according to the people. Chinese people are not exactly the same like Swedish people and so on. So sometimes we have some product that can be a little bit different, even if we try for almost 100%, they are exactly the same. If you purchase a baseball in India or in France or in Ukraine, it will be exactly the same ball. But definitely personalization, it's something that we are working with already in different countries. I know in Singapore, in Canada, in France, we propose in the store to make a 3D scan of your full body, or sometimes just the foot or different parts, in order after to be able for you to know exactly what are the textile or shoes that fit exactly with your body. If you scan your foot, then you will know exactly that for hiking it would be 42, for running it would be 43.5, and for the textile it would be M. And this will allow you also to purchase on internet, and you will be sure that you will make the right choice. You will not take the wrong size and so on, because with Decathlon we have exactly the dimension of your own body. So we'll be able to personalize that.
But to do it, you should be in store, right?
To do it, for the moment, if I'm not mistaken, yes. What we do already in the other country, it's only in the store. Okay. It's only in the store. In the future, we can imagine some partnership with if there is something in maybe with another partner platform and so on that will do this. Then we can, why not to combine to take the data from the other platform and so on. But what we do is our own data. We never give the data to partners, or we never sell them, and so on and so on. So we will not do this from the other side. This for sure. It's in our values.
Let me ask one question, which is very important for us as a leasing agent, and maybe important and for developers too. I want to ask you about competitors and your current vision of competition in Ukraine. We know what your main competitors on Ukraine market, it's Sportmaster and Intersport, maybe something else, somebody else. And of course, you have a huge experience of working with the same brands on other markets. But I think what and Sportmaster and Intersport in Ukraine have some unique features. For example, Sportmaster is not so big and so dominative as in Russia. But Intersport is so big, and it's very in comparison with European Intersports, but it's not in usual locations. It's mostly like part of the DIY store, not like part of shopping center. And my question is, if mall have enough space for all tenants, sport tenants, and for Intersport, and for Sportmaster, and for Decathlon, is it suitable for you? Are you ready to stay near with them, or you will prefer only be like a monopolist, only one in shopping center?
No, I am very open, and I think it's better for the customer also when all the sports are together. So you have different questions. First of all, competition is good. The market of Ukraine, the sport market, it's big. It's a big market. 40 million inhabitants in Ukraine, and many sports are practiced by Ukrainian and so on. So this is a big market, and there is that will continue to grow. So there is place for everyone, for Nike, Adidas, Decathlon, Sportmaster, on Intersport and the other. So no problem. And when there is a competition, we do better. Situation of monopole, you can put the price that you want. You don't care about customer relationship or quality because you are alone. When there is a competition, then I really like it because all of us, we are better. All of us, we try to improve. So it's a challenge, you know. If you make a race and you are alone, you are sure to win. But if you know that you will be 10 and you will have to train and you will have to adapt and you will have to and you will maybe not be the first time, but you will train to do it again and maybe to be the first, you know. So competition is good. Then about our competitors, if you talk about multi-sport retail shops, yes, there is Sportmaster, Intersport, but in big malls like Lavina or Blockbuster or others, there is place for everyone. So I think it will be not a problem to be all together. I have my competitors also, like a brand, you know, we talk about between brands. Then my competitor here, it's Hardee's or I don't know, Cannondale, or it's the brand itself. If I talk about the balls behind me, then it's Nike or it's Adidas, and it's not Sportmaster and Intersport. Or just in front of me on the other side, I have the fishing department and the horse riding department, and we do this in Decathlon, but not in Sportmaster and in Intersport. But in Ashan, you have fishing, so maybe here the competitor is Ashan. So finally, because we are in all segments of sports. First price to a top quality in all the sports for men, women, and kids. And really, I have a lot of different competitors, but it's good. I like it.
Thank you.
So I have a question regarding also very trendy subject. It's about sustainability. We already know that you have in shops, for example, bins for segregation of waste. But the question is more difficult. For example, Adidas has committed to phasing out virgin polyester by 2024. Inditex by 2020 will have invested almost $4 million. Also in France, capital of luxury fashion, there will be, as far as I know, a ban on destruction of unsold collections, and theoretically it will be implemented in 2023. So the fashion industry is extremely energy consuming, and what on the global level, I suppose, not only on the level of Decathlon Ukraine, are the plans of your company regarding this?
Yes, of course, we are a global company. Decathlon, it's we are in 60 countries. We have almost 100,000 employees that work directly for Decathlon, and indirectly it's 1 million people that works indirectly for Decathlon in factories and so on. So it's a big company. So of course we work on that topic since many times. Actually, the company mission of Decathlon, it's to make sport for the many. It's what you see. But the purpose of Decathlon, it's not really known, but the purpose of Decathlon, it's to be useful for people and for the planet. So when we decide something, we make sure that it fits with the Decathlon purpose. So when we make a big decision, is it useful for people? Is it useful for the planet? Mm-hmm. Yes or no? And according to that, we decide. So yes, of course, all the big, signature done with big retailers or big company worldwide, generally Decathlon, we sign them. I know that Decathlon, we will reach 100% of sustainable polyester in 2021. So it's tomorrow. We will reach 100% of sustainable cotton in 2020. So it's today. So here it's, we don't talk about intention, but we talk about action that really show the result here. We have a plan to have 100% of our store with renewable energy. So we have 1,700 hypermarket of sport in the world. And today, 60% of them, they work with renewable energy already. And the other, we will have to switch to renewable energy since 2026. So we have 5 years to reach this 100%. And this is the same target also for our factories. Because the target of Decathlon, a bit more long term, but before 2030, it's to be positive in CO2 for the planet. So we will not be, when I say positive, I say that it's positive for the planet. So finally, we will not consume CO2, but we'll give more CO2.
Okay, thank you.
What we want definitely is to be a climate positive company. So this is in the top 3-4 KPIs of our company. This is the CO2. This is what we see every month in our report and so on. Because we are growing, we have at the same time to decrease our impact. So the more we grow, the more we work to decrease and to finally be positive in CO2 for the planet.
Do you have maybe already some environmental KPI before opening the store?
Here in Ukraine, something very easy to do at the very beginning is to not to destroy goods. So to all the goods that we receive or when there is a small defect and so on, or we reuse, or we if it's possible, we repair, or we give to charity. But in Decathlon, we destroy zero product. So this is something that we do in all the country in the world, I believe, and it's something that we can do since the very first day. There is in our office there is no plastic. We take care of the paper, so we have different bins to recycle the plastic, the glass, the paper, and so on. So just here over there in the office behind me. So we recycle all what enter in the store, we recycle and we don't destroy the product. For example, and we have other plans. Of course, we have a lot of different plans in the factories that we have here in Ukraine. We work in 6 factories to reduce the impact on the energy that we consume, or to reduce the waste that factories can generate and so on. So there is a lot of different KPIs. Me personally, I have as a CEO, one of my KPIs is it's sustainable development.
What about let me ask a question about coronavirus. You as a global company, how you are helped to fight against coronavirus, and can you explain maybe few insights about your famous mask Easy Breathe? Is it really helps in fighting against virus, or it's a joke?
It's a joke. No, it's not a joke. But we are very prudent. I was sure you will ask this question, actually. And you know this, I will show you a video if I can share my screen. Wait 1 second.
Yeah.
Okay, and I will explain at the same time. So the mask Easy Breath, it's a mask that is done for diving. So it's to go on the water, you know. With this mask, you can breathe. So it's this mask actually. So you can breathe under the water. You can go under the water. You have visibility, and the water doesn't enter in the tube, and so on. And finally, during this coronavirus, many countries in the world, in Europe mainly, hospitals, they realize that it can be useful, or to protect, or to breathe. But we have to take care because. For the two different possibilities, you need to have something to adapt. So here you see in this picture, for example, it's to breathe. And so there is engineers and so on, so factories that work to adapt our mask. So what Decathlon did in Europe mainly, actually we give more than 100,000 masks to the hospital, mainly in Europe. So it's more than 100 masks like that. Sometime. So here in this picture is to protect. So the doctors and so on are protected, and there is something on the top that that allows them to breathe normally. Or sometimes it's just to breathe. So all over Europe, all hospitals, because everyone knows Decathlon, they ask us about this mask, and in all this country we give them for free, or sometimes for just a very small amount. So it's working, yes. It's not a joke, because 100,000, it's not a joke. And we want to make sure that it's working well before giving into the hospital. But you need to have something to adapt. if you have it just alone, it's just a mask to dive on the water. But if you have the right adaptator, then you can breathe normally, or you can even breathe better if it's to cure the people in the hospital. So here in Ukraine, we are in contact with the Ministry of Health, and we ask them directly if they are interested and so on. So for the moment, they are investigating to see how they can adapt and so on. It's on the way. We will see.
Thank you. So, Florian, we saw already almost all our questions. And to finalize the discussion, what is your professional challenge for 2020?
Professional challenge for 2020, it's to become stronger following this all this crisis, you know. What I see is that very fast we were able to adapt to improve in e-commerce or to find other way of doing business. In the end of this week, for example, you will be able to find Decathlon products in 20 different Ashan hypermarkets in the country. We will have 2, 5, or 7 meters dedicated to Decathlon products. So like a small shopping shop, like a corner, yes, actually better like a corner. And I'm sure without coronavirus, we would not have these opportunities, or maybe the opportunity to open a shop in Rive Gauche at the end of the week also. So finally, after this, we are stronger because we are better in e-commerce and we develop faster partnership and so on. So probably all this will end positively for us. So the challenge for the end of the year is to be even better than what we planned at the beginning of the year.
Thank you. So we have also 3 questions as far as I see from our audience. The first one, can you give some details if the shops are already open, how they open, in which format, and if you are compliant with all the necessary measures?
Yes, good question. Our store are open since yesterday. According to the law, we are able to open 300 square meters if our store is in front of the parking. So it's what we have chance, because the 2 big stores that we have, they are just in front of the parking, so we have the authorization to open, but just to open for customers 300 square meters. So we give access only to the central alley, and both stores, they have 300 square meters, and for the rest, we have, so I'm behind the fence actually, so on the other side, you have this, and if a customer asks, then we will give them the product directly to them. So they can see like a showroom, and if they want a product, we provide them. So and we provide also, so because I'm not in the place of customer, we provide this at the entrance. We take the temperature at the entrance, make sure that everyone wears the mask if they're in the middle, to respect the distance and everything. And we clean very often all the different places. So we respect all security conditions and even more.
Thank you. Did you have to review the expansion development plan due to coronavirus, or not, maybe?
Yes, we reviewed it, but not because we put less stores in our... Yes, less stores in our plan, but more stores, actually. Because all the discussions that I had before coronavirus, I continue to discuss for development in main cities and here in Kiev. So we didn't change, but we add some other possibilities of development. I talked just before about partnerships, but maybe also with a franchise. It's something that we agreed with the group, with our shareholder, to launch franchise with a partner here in Ukraine. So we are just at the beginning, but we are looking for partners that will be able, that have the experience of retail and will be able to open maybe in other cities where we are not already. And also, like I said previously, to open a smaller format of shops. It's something that we add now in our expansion plan.
You mentioned that now you are also investigating the development in the regions. So what are the cities in priorities, and maybe some soonest opening, not in Kyiv, but in Kyiv?
Yeah, so it's not a surprise. It's the main big cities. It's Lviv, Dnipro, Odessa, and Kharkiv. it's our priority. It's where we investigate. We discuss in all the cities with different owner or to be able to open in the best places. So it's under discussion. There is nothing signed yet, so I cannot say anything. It will not be in 2020. I'm almost sure we will not open in region in 2020, except if something exceptional arrives and so on. But we are already in the middle of the year. But most probably in 2021, we will be able to open somewhere in the region.
And the last question, when you are expecting to be able to open the store in its normal format, not 300 square meters? Maybe you have some information, some expectation.
It's a difficult question. So the normal format of Decathlon, just for people that are listening to you, it's a big box with 3,000-5,000 square meters, like a real and standalone, autonomous, and with a playground and so on and so on. So this is the standard format of Decathlon. Most of Decathlon stores all over the world, they are like that. Here we had the opportunity to have a very good store with citrus and to open in retail park Petrovka, and after another one here in next to Auchan in Lavina. And I am investigated also, but it's difficult in Kiev to find that kind of store. I say it's difficult because we need to find the land. We need to find the place first, and then we need to find the land, and then you need to find the partner that will develop this for us. But we are investigated, and it's part of my own challenge is to be able to find the right place and the right partner and to build these shops in Kiev. Because this is a real Decathlon.
Sorry, we have one more additional question. There is a comment that it's very, very beautiful idea with Easy Breeze, and it is appreciated a lot. I think that's all. Yes. That's all. So thank you very much, Florent, for participating.
Thank you for your full answers.
Answers,
very interesting. Yeah, we understand your strategy. We received your a lot of optimistic
approach.
Yeah. Optimistic approach.
I am.
We wish you great success, huge sales, a lot of clients, and huge development pipeline in Ukraine.
Thank you, Vitaly. Thank you, Ghana.
Thank you for
having us. We will continue next
time. Bye, everyone.
Thank you. Bye.
There is no information with whom, but it will be a good surprise with somebody of international. Thank you very much and see you next week. Bye.
Thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye.